Hello everyone, I'm Tamanna from MATLAB Helper. As the title of the video suggests, today we'll be seeing how to recognize American Sign Language using AlexNet in MATLAB. Let's move on to sign language. Sign language acts as a medium of communication among the deaf and vocally impaired community. In this kind of community, the movement of hands and face play a major role in communication. Unlike vocal community who use their hands to enhance their speech, in sign language, each gesture has a predefined normalized norm for each sign. This allows in the construction of sign language dictionaries in which each sign of the language is equated to one or more words in spoken language. As of now, there is no universal sign language. Different countries or regions have their own sign languages. For example, the French Sign Language, American Sign Language, and the British Sign Language. Most of the countries adopt American Sign Language. American Sign Language is a natural language which is completely separate and distinct from English. It contains all fundamental features of a language with its rules for pronunciation, word formation, and word order. We'll be using a part of ASL, that is American Sign Language Alphabets, also known as American Manual Alphabet, to build a recognition system capable of classifying the given data into spoken language. The data used was downloaded from Kaggle.com. The data consisted of training data set which had 87,000 images of 200x200 pixels. There are 29 classes, of which 26 are for letters A to Z and 3 classes are for space, delete and nothing. Out of the 29 classes, we'll be using 5 classes, that is the vowel dataset A, E, I, O and U. Now let's move on to the MATLAB window and see how to load this data. We start with the CLC clear and close all command. This is used for clearing the command window, the workspace, or closing all the windows that are open. We have saved all the training images in the folder train images. Now we are going to load these images using the data store object. The benefit of using image data store is that the images are automatically labeled based on their folder names and stored as an image data store object. It enables you to store large images that does not fit in memory and efficiently reads these images in batches during training the convolution neural network. So now let's run the code. As you can see, all the images are saved in all underscore images data store object. All underscore images dot files contain all the saved images. Now we have a for loop for resizing the image. Let's run this part of the code and see how it works. We resize the image because AlexNet is pre-trained with images of size 227x227. The resized images are saved in all underscore images dot files. So that means the resized images get saved in the train images folder. Next step is to load the pre-trained AlexNet. The AlexNet, since it is trained using many images, it can be directly used for classification. But in our case, we are going to fine-tune the pre-trained AlexNet to perform classification on a new set of images. The steps involved in reusing a pre-trained network are, first we have to load the pre-trained network. Next, we have to replace the final layers. Next, train the network. Next, we have to predict and assess the network accuracy. And then finally, we have to deploy the results. First, we begin with loading the pre-trained AlexNet. Then we replace the 23rd and the 25th layer with a fully connected layer and a classification layer. For the fully connected layer, we have to specify the number of classes. We have 5 classes, that is A, E, I, O, U. So we set the size as 5. Then we specify the training options, that is the transfer function, initial learn rate, mini batch size, and number of epochs. Then we move on to training the network using the transferred and new layers. Finally, we save the network. Now let us test our saved net. We have saved the net as mynet1. So first we load our net, then we'll provide with the test data, then we are going to resize the data, and then we are going to classify the test data using our saved net. So let's run this code and see how it works. As you can see, our network has properly classified the data as A. Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video if you found it helpful. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Education is our future. MATLAB is our feature. Happy MATLABing!